Yeah, what's up guys, my name is Mr. Freeze 2244 and we're going to be working through the escalations now. I'm aiming for two videos a day, for at least for the foreseeable future anyway. So the first escalation I'm going to be working on, I'm going to be doing them all in order. We're working on the legacy ones first, starting with Paris in the Kotti Paradigm. I'm going to do all three levels here, Silent Assassin, and it's a lot easier than people think it is. And I'm going to show you exactly how easy all three levels are. So we've got no pacifications, we're not allowed that. We need to make sure we're wearing the 47 signature suit, and we need to take her out with the battle axe. So we're going to use the default equipment, we don't need to change anything. We need to start at the main location. You can also start in the garden if you want to, but I tend to like to prefer default locations over anything else. But it doesn't really matter, really. It just gets you a faster time if you want to start in the garden area. Either way, we're doing exactly the same thing. So once we run through this section here, we reach Lisa McKenzie. She's going to be talking to another woman. What we need to do is just bump into her. That will skip their conversation, and that will move Lisa into these bathrooms over here. So while she's doing that, we need to go and grab the battle axe. The battle axe is just going to be over here around the corner. Go and grab that. And she's going to come around the corner, and we're going to get an easy battle axe kill, and her body is going to be hidden, because no one's going to come back through here. Not before we leave. Anyway, so it's going to hide behind this door, close the door, throw it at her head, and then leave the level. Easy. Nice, simple, straightforward Silent Assassin for level 1. They start escalating things a little bit with level 2 and 3, but yeah, I prefer much prefer, having played back through some of these older escalations, I much prefer the 3 levels over the 5. The 5 just seems a bit too much, and it's unnecessary, because it's there's a lot of stages that just don't need it. I think 3 is the perfect number for the escalations, but that's an easy Silent Assassin for level 1. Let's get a confirmation of that. Let's move on to level 2 after that. There we go. Fairly fast time as well. So for level 2, we have an additional target, which is the Sheikh Al-Ghazali. We're not allowed to vault now either, so we can't vault or climb or anything. So it'll result in a mission fail. We need to bring along a lockpick this time, and that's the only change we're going to make. So again, from the very start, we need to distract Lisa McKenzie. Is it Liza or Lisa McKenzie? Liza McKenzie. Well, I'm going to say Liza, because it seems that way. Otherwise, if it was Lisa, it would be an S, surely. But yeah. We're going to take her out exactly the same way, except we're actually going to throw it at her while she's in the bathroom, not behind the door itself, because we need to distract Sheikh Al-Ghazali downstairs as well. So first of all, again, bump her to skip the conversation. Come back in this area over here, go and grab the battle axe. There we go. And then use your lockpick on the door to your right. Now, if you watch your minimap, you will see the Sheikh is just about to come to the doorway, the balcony, I should say. Then what you want to do is just throw a coin outside. That's going to distract him, and he's going to come all the way downstairs to go and investigate what the noise was. So meanwhile, we're just going to grab the battle axe again, and then take out Liza while she's in the bathroom. So that's one down. You can leave her body here, because no one comes back through this bathroom. Now it's just a matter of just waiting for the Sheikh to come down the stairs. He won't take too long. He actually walks quite quickly, fortunately. I think that was a change in Hitman 3 compared to what it was in Hitman 1, because they used to walk quite slowly, which was a bit of a pain in the arse, really, to be honest. Because I don't think there's really a way to speed this up. But once he gets around this area, we can go throw that at his head, and we can leave him there. I'm going to put his disguise on, because it just makes it easy to escape through this area, because we're in trespassing if we don't. And there we go. I think people forget you can actually use this disguise, and it's going to be particularly important for level 3 as well, using this disguise, because we have an additional target for that one, and it requires a few steps to get that done, to isolate this person. So we're just going to exit the mission here, get a confirmation of the Silent Assassin for level 2, and then we can move on to level 3. But the level 3's equipment is going to be exactly the same as before. We're not going to change anything up that. I'm just going to show you the parameters, and then we can move on and show you the guide itself. So there's a confirmation of Silent Assassin for level 2. For level 3, we have an additional target, which is Hayley Brennan. And we need to take her out with the battle axe. And most patrolling guards now can see through all disguises. So, but we're going to avoid all that sort of thing. So you don't really need to worry too much. We're going to run around this way. There's a bodyguard to your right that can see through your disguise. So I've avoided him by sticking to the left here. So we have three targets. We need to take all of them out with the battle axe. And this is really how you do it. It's quite simple. So again, the first two steps are going to be exactly the same as level 1 and 2. This is good because this is where it's escalating. And you're not actually changing too much. So we're going to bump into this woman. Skip the conversation, of course. Open this door, go and grab the battle axe. I hate that lighting effect. You know when it goes dark in a room until it, like, exposes the room itself? I don't like that lighting effect. We're going to unlock this door now, and then we're going to throw a coin outside again to distract Sheikh Al-Ghazali from upstairs. That will get him to come down. I'm going to grab the battle axe now. And take out Liza McKenzie. There we go. Body is well hidden. Just in case you didn't know, she drops an invitation as well. We don't need it for this particular mission, but yeah. Just in case you were actually playing the main mission, if you are looking for another pass, go get one there. So, yeah, we're waiting for the Sheikh right now. We are actually going to hide his body this time because we don't want anyone to discover him. Actually, no. I don't think anyone does discover him, so I'm just going to leave him there, actually. But you can drag him in here if you want to. So I'm just going to take him out here. Go and grab his disguise. Then from this point, we're going to leave the axe here as well. We don't need that. We just need to keep in mind, don't vault anything, don't climb anything. So we're just going to come down these stairs and pass through the basement area. But this is the lighting I was talking about. Look how dark it is until it adjusts to... It's like, I don't know, pupil dilation, I guess. But I don't know why they put that in games. It's not a good look to me. But yeah, on Hitman 3, these old maps just look so dark to me. Even when you turn the gamma up to maximum, it's not good. We're going to pass through this kitchen here. We're not in a trespassing zone with this disguise on, which is good. It's probably the best disguise in the game, apart from Helmut Kruger. So both disguises are really, really powerful in this map. Not sure, quite sure why I went this way. I could have just went the other way, really. Probably would have been faster, because now I have to come through this room because of the enforcers. But yeah, with this disguise, you don't have to get frisked on the stairs either. You can just go straight up. Hope you're enjoying Paris, Sheikh Al-Ghazali. So we need to go into the attic and get the dongle. So we need to interrupt the auction itself. And that's going to cause Haley to come down the stairs with a guard. So I'm just going to follow where I'm going. Let's go into Dahlia's room, pass through that. And we're going to wait for that enforcer to move. He is actually triggered by you or proximity. So once you're close to the area, that's when he'll move. That's how he's always been. But we're going to come into this attic. It's now a trespassing zone, so just watch out for all the guards that are in the room. Wait for an opportunity and go grab the laptop dongle. I'm going to exit the room now and circle the way around and head into the office. Go and inspect the laptop. And then put the dongle into the laptop itself. And there we go, that's everything set up. So Haley's gonna check out the laptop and she's gonna freak out and the guard's gonna tell her to go away. There's an enforcer here on the stairs, so we're just gonna shoot there. That will allow us to get past. Alternatively, you can throw a coin or something. But yeah, we're gonna come down these stairs right here, come down here. And we need to pretty much just wait on these steps, because this is where Haley and her guard's going to come. Her guard's going to be walking several paces in front of her, so it'll give you quite a large window, really, to actually take her out. But what we need to do is go and put our suit back on first, then go and wait back on those stairs. It's going to take a few minutes for her to get everything into place, but we're going to skip through that anyway. So first of all, go and get our suit, and then we'll come back through this area. We have to make sure we go through the same steps, so we can go that way, but I think there's extra cameras in that around there as well, so I'm just going to leave that. Actually, I think I'm thinking of another escalation. I don't think there is a camera on those stairs. Probably thinking of master mode. Never mind. I'm just going to put this suit back on, and then we're going to go back exactly the same route. Also, bring your battle axe. Don't forget it like I have just then. Where is it? There it is. Because this is important. We need this battle axe. Stay crouched so we don't get spotted there. But yeah, we're just going back to the staircase to wait for her to get in position. It's always nice revisiting the old Paris escalations, really. There is a couple of weak ones in there, but this is at least half decent compared to the others, because five levels is just a bit long, really. Just be careful when you come through this kitchen of those two chefs, and make sure they are having their backs to you and they're not looking towards you, because you don't want to get spotted there. But yeah, this is going to take a while for her to come down. She's right there. So let's just skip it to the point when she's actually on the stairs. So about a minute and a half later, this is what I was talking about. The guard's going to come through the room. He's going to exit, and that gives us a little bit of a window to take out Haley. And there we go. And once we can just leave her there. The guard doesn't come back or anything. Don't need to worry about that. Now we just need to escape. And again, it's just coming back to get through this kitchen. We need to just wait for that chef in the far distance to turn around first. So here's me getting a little bit impatient. Whenever you see me do this in videos, you know I'm getting impatient. I'm not sure if he was having a conversation or something. I don't know, because I was listening to music at the time, but I don't know. That's probably what it was. I was just a bit worried that we've broken the AI or something, because it wasn't. It was a bit very, very slow for him to turn around. That's what I was trying to say. We're going to take the old basement exit, and it's like a nice, easy, silent assassin suit only for. Well, it's not suit only technically, because we actually changed the disguise, but it's a nice, easy, silent assassin for the Kotti Paradigm. So let's just get confirmation of that and we can wrap up the video. There we go. Work through these. We'll get these tiers all checked off and we'll start unlocking some more rewards. So yeah, there we go. Not bad time as well, because you can't really speed that up too much, really. But that's going to do it for this video, so thank you very much for watching. Feel free to drop a like if it helped you out. Subscribe if you are new to the channel. And hit the bell notification to be notified of all future videos and live streams. Consider supporting me on Patreon or even becoming a member of the channel by clicking the join button below. Or clicking the link in the description. A big shout out to all my Psycho Assassin members, which is Paul Lilly, Big D, Bedri, Argel, Mark David, Constantine, and the Crazy Jesus. I really do appreciate you becoming Psycho Assassin members. It's the highest tier. If you want your name shouted out as well, just become a Psycho Assassin member. The credits will be updated next month. I'll be reading your name out in the credits too. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Cheers.